A big win for opponents of the state's bridge tolling proposal. A Commonwealth court today permanently blocked the plan, which would have added tolls to 9 interstate bridges. Good evening, I'm Gordon Lesh.
And I'm Liz Kilmer. One of the bridges that would have been included in that plan is along I-79 in Bridgeville. Channel 11's Angie Moreski has been following this breaking news this afternoon. A lot of drivers are going to be happy about this, Angie. What do you know?
Well, Gordon and Liz, this is a major victory for those against the so-called P3 initiative, which stands for public-private partnership. They've been fighting for nearly a year to stop it, and today they got their wish.
A lot of opposition to this.
Bipartisan. Across the board, everybody said, no way, this is a terrible idea.
Washington County resident Peter Linko led a local petition drive to stop P3. It would have meant a toll in both directions on the I-79 bridge between Bridgeville and South Fayette. PennDOT was hoping to require a $1 to $2 toll on as many as 9 bridges throughout the state to help supplement the state's gas tax for road repair. But opponents argued Pennsylvania already has the 3rd highest gas tax in the country and said it wasn't fair to put yet another tax on citizens.
90,000 people were going to have to pay an incredible amount of extra, over $1,000 extra a year just to get to work.
The ruling comes in response to a suit filed by local communities, Bridgeville, South Fayette, and Collier Township. A panel of Commonwealth Court judges ruled in their favor and killed the plan, saying the Department of Transportation did not follow the law in providing specific details for the proposal. In response, the governor's office put out this statement saying, to date, the legislature has failed to offer any solutions beyond their approval of the P3 initiative that will assist the administration's desire to phase out the gas tax. The Wolf administration continues to welcome discussions with the General Assembly on alternative funding sources that can replace the gas tax, which they say is no longer a dependable source of funding. But opponents were adamant this was not the answer.
And the problem is that this project is being done by unelected bureaucrats in Harrisburg who they don't live here. They don't have to struggle with that. There's people that can barely fill up their tank, especially now.
And the governor's office says it is reviewing the decision to determine if they can take any further action. But as of right now, this looks like the end of the road for this bridge tolling proposal. Reporting live in the studio tonight, Angie Moreski, Channel 11 News.